So today we will be talking about the evolution of computer, how a computer that we use today evolved from a simple invention or a computing device like abacus. We will be discussing about its journey. So let's start it. Please like, share and subscribe to our channel before starting the video. So our first computing device was abacus, which was invented by Mesopotamians in 3000 BC and later on developed by Chinese. It consisted of beads which were divided into two parts and were movable in rods. Simple calculations like addition and multiplication could be done by changing the position of the beads. The next computing device was Napier's Logs and Bones. It was invented by John Napier around 1550 to 1617 AD. This device consisted of numbered rods, which were total 10 in number. These rods were used to perform multiplication of any numbers by 2 to 9. Next device is our Blaise Pascal's adding machine. It was invented in 1642 by Blaise Pascal. This machine consisted of gears which were used to add numbers. This machine consisted of tooth wheel which had unique position, and rotation of this wheel controlled the addition and subtraction operations. And this machine was totally automated. Next device is our Leibniz calculator. In 1671, a German mathematician, Gottfried Leibniz, improved this Blaise Pascal's adding machine and made it capable of performing multiplication and division as well. Next device is our Jacquard's loom. It was invented by Joseph Jacquard in 1801. Joseph Jacquard invented punch cards and later on used it to control the looms. The entire control of the weaving was automated and was controlled by a program. Next device is our Babbage's difference engine. So Charles Babbage was known as the father of computer. Let me tell you why. He was a professor of mathematics and he invented the Babbage's difference machine in 1822 to calculate simple logarithmic tables with higher degree precision. And the difference engine was also capable of calculating and performing various mathematical functions such as polynomials. Charles Babbage designed an analytical engine in 1833, which was general purpose machine and is considered the ancestor of our modern day computer, and this is the reason why Charles Babbage is also known as the father of the computer. So this analytical engine was mainly a conceptual phase which was never completed in the form of a real machine. The analytical engine was capable of performing functions which were based on programs. This analytical engine introduced some concepts that are used in modern day computers. These were central process, storage area, memory, input and output devices, and the concept of comparison and modified storage memory. Now we will be talking about the first program. In 1834, inspired by the concept of analytical engine, Ada Byron created plans for making a machine that could calculate simple Bernoulli's number. And this is regarded as the first program. And that is why she is also known as first programmer. US Department of Defense has also named a programming language Ada in 1979 to honor her. The next computing device that we'll talk about is Hollerith's machine. In 1887, Hermann Hollerith fabricated the first electromechanical punch card translator that used punch cards for input and output and instructions. This was used by US Department of Census to compile 1888 census data and was able to complete the compilation of 10 years of census data within just 3 years. So later on, Hermann Hollerith founded International Business Machine, IBM, to market this technology. Next machine we will talk about is our first electronic computer. In 1939, the first prototype of electronic computer was assembled by John Atzoff and Clifford Barry, which was completed in 1942 using 300 vacuum tubes. This was also known as the first generation of computers. John Atzoff came up with the concept of binary numbers. Next, we will talk about the Mark 1. In 1943, Professor Howard Aiken constructed Mark 1. It was an automatic general purpose electromechanical computer. It could multiply 2 10-digit numbers in just 5 seconds, which was a record at that time. Next machine we will talk about is ENIAC. It was a first generation computer and it was developed by Presper Eckert and John Mackley in 1946. It was made up of 18,000 vacuum tubes in a 30 by 50 feet room. And this way the first generation of computer or the electronic computers evolved. And in this device, programming was done by plugging wires into a patch panel, and this resulted in operation of tasks that was 5,000 times faster than the Mark 1. The next concept that we'll talk about is John Van Neumann architecture or stored programming concept, which was introduced by Dr. John Van Neumann in 1946. This concept suggested the stored program concept, and some concepts were introduced that were data and instructions were stored in a single read-write memory. The memory contents are addressable by location. Execution takes place in a sequential fashion from one instruction to the next unless modified explicitly, and all these concepts are used in our modern day computers that we use today. This was the journey of the computer and the evolution of computer. And that was all for today. Thank you for watching the video. We will talk in the next video again. Till the time, thank you. Have a nice day.